Good morning, it's day 54.
Take this pink ribbon off my eyes. I'm exposed and it's no big surprise. Don't you think I know exactly where I stand? This world is forcing me to hold your hand.
Hear my squeaky car? This is the end of my breakfast, Special K strawberry bar. I'm on my way to go shopping. I have about 2 hours to shop today before we have to go to church. Or until we get to go to church. How about that? I should have brought a bottle of water because I'm like really thirsty. I just put some gum in my mouth. That dentine ice, oh my god, that'll make you not want to eat for like 2 hours. It tastes like cough syrup. It is 10:15, we are heading out to church momentarily. I am hungry, but I don't know what to grab. Oh boy. Guess I'll grab an apple. I'm having a pear, big one.
This is a chicken fresco taco from Taco Bell. One serving of sun chips and one serving of hummus for lunch.
So I ended up putting a little smear of sour cream on my fresco taco. It was only 1/3 of 40 calories, whatever that is, about 13 calories, so no big deal. And I put the verde sauce on that. That can't be more than like a couple calories, so I'll work that out. What else is going on? Shopping, church, lunch, hubby left, kids are chilling, baby's going to be going down. I got to stop calling her a baby, she's 2 years old now. She's going to be going down for a nap in about a half an hour to 45 minutes. I got some chores to do, upload these videos, check my YouTube, check my subscription box, fun, fun, fun. I'm going to have one of these new fused drinks that I just picked up today for 26 cents. This is Slender Rise Fruit Tropical Punch, Vitamins A, C, and E, and Super Critomax. 10 calories. See how it tastes. Well, you guys, I have to say, today is a tough day. Today is a day where I need you, all my YouTube friends, to support me. I'm having a tough day, tough minute, tough hour with the diet, the weight loss. I'm experiencing a plateau right now with my weight loss, and it's really bothersome to me. I weighed like 172.2 or something this morning. So I've been sticking about the same for almost 2 weeks now, up and down, and I've been really good. I haven't had a cheat day in a while, like a week and a half. And I said I wasn't going to have one until I hit the 160s, so I didn't get to go out to eat today for Mother's Day or anything. Because I'm not going to spend hard-earned money on a salad. And I know so many of you have given their opinions and their advice or just their advisement about weighing yourself often and about how this can be detrimental because it can, I can't find the word right now, but it can be deceiving, you know? But I know myself, and I have the advantage of having the experience before. So I know a bit more what to expect now. But that still doesn't make this plateau any easier. But I know that without the little losses each day when I'm actually losing, I would have probably given up weeks ago. And maybe that makes me a really weak person. Maybe it's just a personal preference. Maybe it's me having the need to control everything and feeling like I have more control if I know what the number says every morning. But of course, here is the blaring truth that I am getting smaller. I gave you guys my measurements yesterday. I've lost even since last week that I did my measurements. Vlogging. I've lost inches even just from the week prior, so say it with me, everybody. Comment below. Let me hear it a million times. But you're getting smaller. Isn't that what you want? To get smaller, to get healthier. I can't be getting any less healthy, eating better foods, eating less, eating the right amount, exercising more. I can't be worse off now. I'm getting smaller. I'm getting towards my goal. I'm moving in the direction of those size 7 jeans. I'm moving in the direction of my thighs not rubbing together anymore. I'm moving in the direction of my pants not cutting the fat in my stomach in half and having it hang over the top. I'm moving towards that goal. But when that scale defeats me in the morning, I just think, why am I doing this? Why don't you just make yourself happy and just go get a milkshake? Just seems like a whole lot of effort for not a lot of payout when you don't seem like you're getting paid out. But when I have a rational thought, that thought is that it is paying off. I just had a Reese's miniature. I'll put the calories right here. I'm eating a light Sargento string cheese for 50 calories. And Alana just woke up from her nappy. You got some bedhead, girl.
Did you help on it? Did you?
Say hi.
Hi. Hi.
Well, ever the bargain shopper I am, we're on our way to the Goodwill. That's about it. Oh, I forgot to tell you guys that last night, right before I went to bed, I was trying to pick out some clothes to throw on for this morning so that I could just get dressed real quick before I ran out to go shopping. And I was looking through all these jeans that I have in my closet. It's so ridiculous. I have jeans anywhere from like size 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. I think I even had like a pair of 18s in there. All hanging up. It's like, it's so ridiculous. But anyway, I told you guys, you'll see in the opening credits or whatever to my vlog, that I can squeeze into a regular 13-14. Well, I got these free jeans a couple months ago at Target, and I'm pretty sure they're like junior sizes. I don't know if they say juniors, but they run really small. And I was able to squeeze into a size 15 of those, which that's the first pair of those new free jeans ones that I got, which I got like six pairs or something. It's the first pair that I've been able to actually squeeze into. They're kind of low-waisted, kind of dark denim, so that was pretty cool. Yep, so that's it. Just got out of Goodwill. I am like really hungry and tired and lazy and not wanting to make anything for the girls to eat and not wanting to make anything for myself to eat, and I am so tempted to go through the drive-thru right now. But I'm not gonna do that. I'm gonna go home. So, although my kids are loud and maybe crying in the back, I'm gonna tell you that we're on our way home, and I've come to the conclusion that since I am really craving fast food and a milkshake, I believe I have about 550 calories left for the day. So what I'm gonna do with those calories is that I'm going to have a protein shake to curb my craving for a milkshake. So then that's down to 300 calories. And then I'm going to reserve myself 150 calories for my mango sorbet tonight, because that was really good last night for dessert. That's 150 calories, so that leaves me 150 calories more. And with that, with my protein shake, either before or after, I'm going to have whatever that'll get me in chicken nuggets that I'm going to make for the girls. And possibly a couple bites of sweet potato, baked sweet potato that I made a couple days ago, leftovers. So that's my plans for dinner. Yes, it's unconventional, but if it gets me past a craving, then that's what I'll do. I gotta stick with it, right?
So there's my yummy looking protein shake. I didn't put as much of the protein powder in there because the strawberries, I had to use that smoothie kit that I showed you that I bought the other day, and it was strawberry and bananas. But I didn't even know that it had little pieces of frozen yogurt in it, too. So, and not only that, I forgot to mention that I was adding spinach to this. So, I'll work out the calories, but it should be just about the same. And then I'm going to eat 2.5 dinosaur-shaped chicken nuggets with mustard. That's my dinner. There's my chicken nuggets. Yum.
Wow. Well, it's Mother's Day. And I'm sure it has everything to do with it being Mother's Day, but although I felt pretty down today about my weigh-in this morning, I have lots of reasons to feel good. And one of those reasons is that I'm sure any of you mothers out there can relate to this. Some days you feel like a good mother, maybe even a great mother, an accomplished mother, and other days you feel like not so good of a mother. I don't know if there's been days that I've really felt like I'm a bad mother necessarily, but there's definitely days that I know that I didn't do as great of a job as I could have. And in thinking about this, before I came in here to record this, I was thinking about this book. And it's Feeling Good, The New Mood Therapy. And I was in the Air Force. I was a mental health technician. And so I'm a little bit familiar with CBT, which is cognitive behavioral therapy. And that's what this book mainly focuses on. And what the basis of that is that you, the depression and bad feelings are based upon bad thoughts that produce those feelings, and then those feelings lead to behaviors. So if you're having undesirable behaviors and feelings, then you need to change your thoughts first. But anyway, that isn't specifically having to do with what I wanted to say isn't specifically about that. It's more something that was mentioned in this book. So he has an exchange with a woman that is having trouble because she feels like she's a bad mother. And he pretty much just kind of has this exchange with her back and forth and kind of talks her around in circles so that she has to admit that really bad mother doesn't exist. He says here, they're just people, and people do a whole variety of things, good, bad, and neutral. Bad mother is a fantasy. There is no such thing. The chair is a thing. A bad mother is an abstraction. Do you understand that? And it would make a lot more sense if you could hear the whole exchange. He says, yes, there are all degrees of effectiveness at parenting skills, and most everyone has plenty of room for improvement. The meaningful question is not, am I a good or bad mother, but rather, what are my relative skills and weaknesses, and what can I do to improve? So that's really just what I wanted to share with you, but anyway, it's a good book if you want to read it. So in thinking about this, ever since I've read it, it's really hard when you are a mother, at least in my experience. I can't talk for anybody else because I don't know, maybe I'm a total anomaly in this area, but I don't think I am. It's really hard not to judge yourself as a good or a bad mother. Motherhood is so much unlike anything else in the world. I mean, obviously there's fatherhood, but I think that that's kind of completely different, unless you're in that kind of motherhood role. Anyway, to make a long story longer, I just feel really positive, and I feel like I did a great job today, I guess. And maybe you can equate that to any other kind of job. Even though motherhood isn't really a job, it's a lifestyle, and it's an all-day, everyday thing. But when you're at a regular job, you have those days where you feel accomplished, where you got a lot done, where you felt like you just really did a good job, and other days where you just don't, I guess. The reason why I'm putting this in my weight loss vlog is because everything affects my weight loss, especially, or my lack of weight loss, especially in my feelings. And the fact that I realize that, I think, is a milestone in its own. Because eating and getting fat just wasn't an accident. And although, yes, I did start this weight loss journey at only 185 pounds, I have been obese, you know? I know what it's like. I know how I got there. And if I wouldn't have stopped myself where I was at 185, I would have gone back there. I mean, I was just on my way up, 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 up. I mean, there was no end in sight. So just because I didn't get to 300 pounds yet doesn't mean that I wasn't on the right track to get there. You know what I mean? So the fact that I understand that everything in my life and my feelings and thoughts about everything in my life lead to my eating and my lack of motivation and my lack of self-esteem, and it's all rolled into one for me. Some people, their weight isn't an issue like that, but for me it is. So I just wanted to share that with you guys. I think part of the situation with the motherhood thing is that in church today, they obviously talked a lot about motherhood. And I think I use that as a springboard to try my best to be, as they were saying in church, of noble character. You know, I've got to think more about the long run in my children's lives. Not just right now, whether I want to raise my voice and lose my patience because I'm annoyed or aggravated or agitated, or because for some reason I think that that's of the utmost importance that they learn their lesson about this one thing right now. I've got to think in the long run that I need my children's foundation to be strong, and that foundation is built by me and their father first. And they've got to have a soft place to fall with me. And I need to build that relationship now, and not just always be correcting, 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 losing patience, raising voice, correcting, and so on and so on and so on. And I did a dang good job today at being patient, at being loving, at being kind, at enjoying the little moments. And so I'm proud of that. And even though my day didn't start out the first 10 minutes very well, it's really been on the upswing ever since, so I can't complain. See you guys tomorrow.